Next on Local Flavor, we're cooking inspired Mexican cuisine. You're gonna love it. Stay tuned. Hello and welcome to Local Flavor. I'm Chef Costa Magoules. Joining me on the set tonight is my favorite lovely wife, Yvonne. Oh my goodness.
Hi. How are you? Away.
You trying to tell us something tonight? Is it some kind of special cuisine?
I'm celebrating Mexican cuisine with this wonderful sombrero.
Are you actually going to wear that through the whole show?
No, it's kind of fun to wear right now, though. I don't think I can cook it.
I know that's the one you used to dance in and everything. So
our secret. Stop.
Okay. Listen, folks, I want to remind you this is a call-in show. Remember, call in. The number is 1-800-901-9238. You know, we'll answer all your questions about Mexican. Yvonne knows everything about Mexican. So call in. Don't forget, get it on the walls, put it on the paper, 1-800-901-9238. Okay, well, we have a lot of great local talent in Mexican cuisine here in Daytona Beach and the surrounding area. So we decided to try a Port Orange restaurant called La Fiesta to see how they do Mexican.
Welcome to La Fiesta. My name is Carlos Gallardo. I'm the general manager of the La Fiesta Mexican restaurant in Port Orange. La Fiesta was opened in 2014. They've been in business since then. They specialize in fresh cuisine, fresh Mexican cuisine. All we use fresh products, local products. All the salsas, the ingredients that we use to make recipes fresh and daily. I've been here for the last 8 years and I've grown with this company so much and I admire them and love to be part of this team. I actually started as a bartender. I love bartending, mixing drinks and all that, and I took a love for the food and see the passion the family has for it, the cooks and everybody. And making fresh meals using fresh ingredients. What's on the menu? My favorite dish, my to-go dish, is mari tierra. Mari tierra is a skirt steak with queso and on a bed of cilantro rice. Very delicious. That's just my to-go dish.
Welcome back, and this is how we do it here on Local Flavor. We're going to be doing some cooking. Before we get started, we want to talk about the history of Mexican a little bit, okay? It's pretty diverse. It started off with the Mayan Indians, who were really like to eat corn tortillas, and they had bean paste and type of things like that. And then the Aztecs came along, and they kind of added game to turkey and different things to their cuisine. They also brought in red hot peppers. And then the Mexicans' cuisine was advanced by the Spanish. Back in the 1500s, they brought all kinds of things to the cuisine, because they brought in poultry, they brought in cows, they brought in pigs, they brought in citrus, they did all those things. So you can see Mexican has a really rich, diverse background. So we're going to start off and really get started here to see what we're going to do. We're going to do a taco, and the recipe is going to come up. Okay, everybody, now let's take a look at what's on there, okay? And there is the recipe card. And this is the tortilla. Well, we're going to do the guacamole dip. Okay, we can start with the guacamole dip. Ivan, you need to make the guacamole dip, okay?
Okay.
So well, get your guacamole and get ready. What are you doing with that mixer?
I am going to mix the ingredients together.
Well, you got all your ingredients up there, okay, and it's all set to go, but it doesn't say anything about using a mixer.
Then how am I going to mix it together?
Oh, we're going to do this the Mexican way, okay?
Oh,
we're going to use a mortar and pestle. You're not getting away that easy, okay?
Okay?
See this, gang? This is the real deal, all right? There's your mortar and pestle.
Okay.
All right, you ready?
Well, let me
now,
get ready
the
here.
Guacamole dip has tomatillos in it. It's a type of tomato. And this is what it looks like. It looks kind of funky with a shell on it and everything.
Okay, and that's
but then you peel that off, and I chop those up for you, okay?
Yes,
so you
thank
put
you.
Those in, tomatillos.
All right. All right.
They got like a lime lemony taste to them. And then you're gonna put cilantro.
Okay, here's some cilantro.
Okay, you seem like you're doing pretty good there so far. And then you put some.
What's this?
This is serrano pepper.
Okay.
We're gonna add a little heat to it, okay?
Okay.
Isn't that something?
All right.
Okay, you don't want to eat this by itself.
And then
and garlic.
Oh, garlic. You put garlic in everything.
Put garlic in everything. It's got to have garlic. Then mash that all up, girl.
Okay, with this masher?
Yeah, you just squish it around it. Come on, get in and get serious with it.
Like this?
And we're going to put guacamoles in it. And
guacamoles? Avocados, I know that.
I was waiting for you to say something.
We turn it into guacamole.
Here's the avocado. You take it, you actually just split it. And I'll show you here in a minute.
Am I
cut
doing
it in
this
half,
right?
Then just turn it, okay? There's that big seed. You want to take seed home, don't you?
Yeah, I want to take the seed home, see if I can grow a plant.
You know, you do that every time. You put it on the windowsill with a toothpick in it, and it sits there for 3 months and never grows, okay?
No, and then one day it grows a tree.
Well, then what you do is you take a spoon, and you just dip it right out inside like this. And then you put it right in. You ready? You're putting it in there already, aren't you?
Yeah, well,
here, you can have this, too.
I mushed up everything else.
Mush it up. Mush it up.
Okay.
While she's mushing that up, I'm going to be making the tacos. Oh, that's looking pretty good there, lady.
It smells good.
How's that thing work?
It's very heavy, but I have to get used to it. I guess I could.
Okay, now we're going to do taco tonight, too, okay? Recipe card's been up and gone, but don't worry about it. It's on our Facebook page. I took ground beef, garlic, cilantro, geez, surprise, surprise, onions, and I cooked it down. And it takes quite a while to cook, so that I got it started early. But I did a little twist to this. I added salsa to it. And I got it cooking here. And I got to tell you, look at this. Isn't this beautiful? Look at that. Ivan, eat your heart out over there.
Right? I will later.
You will later? Yeah, this is looking pretty good. What you do is cook it down, and I've got it cooking, simmering real nice. So we have the taco recipe going, and then how's that look? Let me see this.
I finished it.
They got it. You can shoot this right on the camera. Isn't that beautiful? You like that?
I like it.
Like it a lot?
I like it a lot.
This is a jalapeno, okay? And jalapenos, this is the jalapeno right here. And a lot of people think jalapeno's too hot, right? Well, let me show you something. Take and cut the skin off, but you don't want to get the seed. If you get the seed inside, it's going to be very, very hot. Now, here's a little piece of jalapeno, Ivan. Trust me.
I trust you.
Okay. Oh, boy.
Just tastes like green pepper.
That's all it tastes like.
It's
but if you put you get the seed in there, it's going to get your attention. Now, we use the serrano peppers in the guacamole dip,
mm-hmm.
and that's got a little heat to it, okay?
All right.
So when you taste that, would you want to taste it down there at all?
No. I'll trust you that it's hotter than a jalapeno.
Oh, my goodness gracious. All right, how are we doing on time here, gang? Don't forget, this is a 1-800-901-9238 show. You need to call in and give us some questions, all right? And we're going to be going to another restaurant here in a minute, but we want to go ahead and finish up our tacos. The meat is ready, and then we're going to, later on, Ivan's going to make tortillas from scratch, okay? And that'll be interesting. I'm going to make some fajitas.
Fajitas.
I mess that word up all the time. I used to call them fajitas. And Ivan would get so mad at me. He said, it's not fajitas, it's fajitas. And this is jalapeno. jalapeno.
Jalapeno.
Not jalapeno. Jalapeno. It's
right.
Jalapeno, okay? See, I'm learning all kinds of stuff. You know what you forgot to put in there?
Lime I couldn't juice. See the recipe card. Lime? Okay.
And I got this magic squeezer. I'm going to put it right in.
And the lime juice keeps the avocado from turning brown, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. It's very, very important that you do that, okay?
That smells good.
Okay, so here we go. As I was telling you about the tomatillas, they got this really funky shell on the outside, mm-hmm. okay? But then once you take it off, it's really pretty inside. And then if you cut it, it kind of looks like a melon.
Tomato or a melon, yep.
Well, you don't see all the seeds and everything in it. It's kind of thing, but it's got a very interesting flavor, too. I'm going to experiment with you.
Okay.
I'm sorry, that's why you're here. You got to taste things.
Oh, I can taste that. It's kind of refreshing, almost like a citrus flavor.
Yeah, it is. It's got
flavor.
Kind of a limey kind of taste mm-hmm. to it and everything.
Mm-hmm,
but it's
good.
Amazing to me how the jalapeno doesn't have a whole lot of seed. It's not going to give you the heat. But the Serrano, that will give you some heat. And this is the poblano. This is another big pepper they use.
I like those stuffed with cheese and fried.
Yeah, these are really good.
Yeah, well, I'll go off my diet for one of those stuffed peppers.
You know, we would have done beans and rice because that's a big Mexican dish, okay? But we figured everybody do beans and rice. But, you know, the Mexicans are pretty smart. You eat beans with rice. You don't eat beans by themselves. For one reason, you want to be real nice to your neighbors and friends. It just doesn't digest real well. But if you eat beans and rice together, it kind of works pretty good.
Okay.
Everybody's happy, okay? All right, we're going to keep moving. I put some taco seasoning into this wonderful taco meat that I was cooking, and I worked all afternoon putting these herbs together, okay? And let me show you what I took this thing. Oh, did you see this package?
A shortcut.
Well, I got to tell you, when you're cooking, you know, it's sometimes I could put all these herbs and spices together, but everybody at home, are you kidding? You're not going to put 10 spices together. So you just take this little bag and you open it up. I can't even open it. Look at that. But I can sure cut it open. I can guarantee you that. And then it comes right out. And look.
Oh, I could do that.
You could do that. You have taco seasoning. Perfect every time.
That's right.
So I added some to this taco meat. Oh, man, look at that. You sure you don't want to try this?
Nope.
Wait a minute.
Wait.
I'm going to put some hot sauce in it. No.
Okay,
here we go. Don't forget, folks, this is a call-in show, 1-800-901-9238. I want you to try it in Stumpy Van tonight, which shouldn't be too hard, actually.
Because I know nothing about Mexican cooking.
I'm going to start heating up my oil, too, for our next dish coming up. The fajitas is like a steak. You're going to really like this a lot. I know the crew's out there going, fajitas, all right, man. Okay, folks, let's get ready to look at another restaurant. This will be fun. Everybody, now let's take a look at some more Mexican talent here on Local Flavor. Say hello to our friends downtown at Tia Corey's.
Hi guys, welcome to Tia Corey's. My name is Jose. My title is manager, and I've been working here on Tia Corey's for 3 years. Food, we sell tacos and a lot of stuff. We got like fajitas. We also got like, which is Mexican torta. It's really good. It's like, it's kind of burger, but it's Mexican style. Yep, it's Mexican style. So we make it like chicken, steak, shredded beef. Yeah, we can do it like, with sausage. Well, we got a lot of kind of meats too. Well, right here, I love everything. Tacos, burritos, the steak with onion and jalapeno tomatoes, and also milanesa, which is really good too. Tamales, red tamales, green tamales, really good. I love our food, it's really good. flavor and everything.
Thank you to our friends down at Tia Corey's. That was really great. Man, they got some great food, too.
Yeah, I like the tamales, just like that fella said.
Oh, yeah. Well, we're getting ready now to do some more cooking, gang. Don't forget, 1-800-901-9238. I can't wait to get into all this food. Now, we're going to do fajitas here in just a minute. I'm heating up the oil now, and I have peppers and onions. I'm going to put them on and simmer a little bit. But before I do that, I'm going to look at Yvonne. She's going to make some tortillas from scratch, the way you're supposed to make them. And I believe that recipe card should be coming up, I hope.
Okay, it's 2 cups.
And it's coming in. Hang on a second. Mm-hmm. They're going to get the recipe card. She's going to make it. There's the recipe. It's so hard. It's got 2 ingredients, flour and water. Gosh. Can you mix that, you think?
This is something I can do with two
ingredients.
Let's
see. We're going to find out here.
In a minute.
Okay, go ahead and put all your water in, girl.
All right.
All right, that's it. 1.5 cups of water and 2 cups of this masa flour, gluten-free. It's all corn.
Okay, corn is
And you know what?
Good.
The recipe's right on the back of the bag.
I cheated.
Okay, what are you doing there?
Okay, I'm just mixing it. So you said to mix it till it's, like, moist.
Go ahead and squeeze it out and see if you can roll one. There you go.
Okay, I guess
now,
I could.
We were down in Guatemala several years ago. And the ladies down there were making the tortillas like this, and they were slapping them back and forth with their hands. I tried that, and it kept falling apart. How about you?
Yeah, I wasn't very good at it either.
Yeah, I'm not good at that either. Okay.
But I learned. They showed me I could do this.
What are you
doing? The ladies were so sweet. They said, get the plastic wrap and put that over, and then get your rolling pin.
Well, I thought you were going to use that to beat me with.
That's the alternate use.
I'm going to be putting these onions on while she's rolling that. Oh, listen to that. Woo! Okay, you got a tortilla there?
I think so.
Okay, let's look at it.
Let's take a peek. Hopefully it'll stay together. I did it. See? Well, I did it.
We got a question from Michael on the line. What's your question, Michael? Hey, Michael. Michael, let's roll the bowl. Hey, Michael, what's going on, partner?
Hey, I noticed that you had the oil in the pan and then you heated the pan.
Yeah.
I had always heard for some reason you were supposed to heat the pan before you put the oil in.
Smart Alec, you know.
Smart Michael.
I don't know.
Actually, Michael, you're right. You're absolutely right, but what I did is I cheated a little bit tonight, okay? Because it takes about 10 or 15 minutes to cook this. So I had preheated the pan already, and then I put the oil in. So that thing was ready to go. So when I put my onions and everything, it was cooking. But you're absolutely right. You should do that. And you have to be careful. That pan can't be too hot because the oil sometimes will scorch. You know, you can't just use any oil either. Olive oil cooks at a lower temperature. Regular soybean or vegetable oil is really better to saute with because it'll take higher temperatures. Hope that answers your question. Now listen, let me look at this tortilla she made. Holy cow, it actually worked. Now what you do with this tortilla is you put it in a frying pan and you toast it. I need 50 of those.
I don't have enough for 50.
Well, what did you come on the show for? We need to have 50.
You said I needed to make one.
Well, you're a pain in the neck. Guess what? I made 50 for you. There you go.
I don't know that you couldn't make these all look the same.
You don't think I rolled those out?
No, I really don't.
Oh, man, look at this.
But they do look very
cooking
nice.
Cooking so good. Oh, doesn't that smell good?
It
y'all smell
good
that out there? Everybody in Deltona and Deland and area, you smell it? Yeah, everybody on the cruise says, yeah, that smells pretty good. Now, what you do is you just really kind of cook those down a little bit, and then you put it all on the side. And then we're going to put the steak in here that we're going to make the fajitas out of. And we're going to cook those. You hear those cooking? Everybody's going, steak? Is he cooking steak?
I know, it smells so good.
It really does. Actually, when you're making fajitas, you should be using like a skirt flank steak, and you cut it on the bias. But I came across these steaks here, and I said, you know what? I'm just going to use these. These are pretty nice. And then you cook them separately, because if you cook the vegetables with the steak, the vegetables are going to be done real quick, and the steak is still raw. So I kind of sautéed off the vegetables a little bit. Mm-hmm. Sauté means cook them down a little bit, okay? I'm trying to teach you as we go here. Okay. Can you clean up your mess over there? You didn't make 50, okay? Just stick that thing away somewhere.
I don't know that I can make
five. And then you
can
put your lovely tortillas that you made, well, sort of made. There we go.
All right.
Isn't that special?
There we go.
Now I got these steaks cooking, and in a few minutes what I'm going to do is pull the steaks off. I'm going to cut them on an angle.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. And then we're going to put them back in with the onions. Wouldn't that be something?
And then wrap them in these?
Well, everybody will come along and wrap them. They'll put, you know, guacamole. Actually, what they do is they take a little guacamole dip. You got your spoon handy? Yeah, it doesn't matter. They do this and kind of mix it up real good. Then you put your onions and your meat right on top of it.
I like that.
How's that sound?
I like that idea a lot.
I do, too. I'm going to cook this a little bit longer. Don't forget, folks, 1-800-901-9238, okay?
Are flour tortillas as easy to make as the corn tortillas?
What was that?
The flour. Now, we were using the corn flour.
Yeah, that's what they make it out of.
Is it just as easy to make them out of flour, like
no,
wheat flour?
You would never
do that?
Flour?
I don't know.
We're talking about corn flour here, not flour, that bleached out stuff that you can't do anything
so
with.
You can't substitute.
I can't
is what
do anything with
me.
You, I swear. Corn flour, gang.
Okay.
Stone ground corn flour. Okay, we're going to be cooking up a storm here in just a minute. Now, I put taco seasoning on my steak, too. Put that over here. That's going to give it a little bit of heat, I believe. Oh, man, look at this. You think this is cooking pretty neat, gang? Well, look at that shot. Isn't that great? Oh, here we go. I'm telling you. And then what you do, I'll put one over here on the side since you forced me into it. We'll get one of those. Look at that steak, okay?
Oh, that looks good.
I'm going to trim some of this fat off. I know you don't like fat, okay?
Yeah, trim the fat off.
Yeah, I figured that. Okay. But then you trim it like this. Then you would put it right on top, okay? And then you could put a little salsa on top of that. Look at that. That's pretty nice.
Hey, what about the vegetables?
You would be like that, wouldn't you?
Well, you went through the trouble of cooking them.
There you go, okay? There it is all wrapped up. I'll be back in a few minutes.
Okay.
Well, you don't think I will give it to you.
Should I watch the steaks?
Yeah, have you watched the steaks? We're in trouble.
I don't think that's a good idea.
But that's how you do it, gang, okay? And just a minute, I'm going to go cook this a little bit more. It's still a little bit too pink for everybody. And now, while it's cooking, because it's almost done, oh, yeah, that thing is really going. We can put everything back in. How's that, huh?
Okay, that looks good. Smells even better.
Yeah, it does. If I would have cooked them together, mm-hmm. the onions and the peppers would have burned, really, before the steak was done, okay? Okay. Don't forget, folks, 1-800-901-9238. We'd love to hear from you. Evan even can answer a question once in a while. It's amazing. I like that tomatillo, don't you?
Yeah, it's like a vegetable with a prize inside. You just kind of peel it open.
With a prize inside?
Well, yeah, because it's
got a cracker box, Jack.
It comes in its own wrapper. I think that's kind of cool.
Okay. It looks nice outside when you take the wrapper. It looks kind of terrible with that. You know what else I'm going to do here? Ooh. Okay, gang, we're going to have to wrap this up tonight. Okay, we've been having fun, and this is... So we're going to be getting ready to take the steaks out. We're going to cut it up. We got the taco meat done. Evan, mm-hmm. you've been doing a pretty good job tonight. I have to admit, you made tacos tortilla shells.
And I actually made guacamole for the first time ever. I usually buy it in a container because you're not
And you
home
use
to
it in the
it.
Right mold and everything, too.
Yeah, this lava rock is really nice. Very heavy, though.
That's just amazing. Okay, well, we're getting close to the end of the show here. Look at this thing. It's just going like crazy. I love it. I love it. Okay, here we go. Look at this. And look at this. Guacamole. Ooh! Okay, folks, that's about all the time we have. And check your recipes on Facebook. And you can always watch us on YouTube again. Have more fun. Just search for Local Flavor. If you didn't get your questions answered, email us at wdsctv@daytonastate.edu. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next week on Local Flavor.